the president of MWA, writers, publishers, editors, and agents have been trying to bribe me to find out who won the best novel award. And since I'm from Chicago, I took all the bribes. However, Marjorie knows that I have very little impulse control, and so she refused to let me know. So I'm as in the dark as everyone else in the room. Camille Minichino is going to present the award for best novel. She's a retired physicist turned crime writer. I can only do one thing. I'm so really grumpy and envious of all these people who do many, many things and then also write really brilliant mystery novels. So Camille, who has written under three different names and has used her math and science background to create really intricate mysteries in those areas, will give us the winner of the best novel.
Well, like Tom, I love numbers. So I have to tell you that there were 523 submissions for best novel this year. That meant 402 gunshot wounds, 79 stabbings, assorted poisonings by colorless liquid. And we hung around with hitmen, serial killers, the occasional ex-spouse who went into a rage. It was a great year. So thank you all for this great year. And among those books, here are the nominees for Best Novel. This Dark Road to Mercy by Wiley Cash. HarperCollins Publishers, William Morrow. Wolf by Mo Hayder. Grove Atlantic, Atlantic Monthly Press. Mr. Mercedes by Stephen King. Simon and Schuster, Scribner. The Final Silence by Stuart Neville. Soho Press. And Saints of the Shadow Bible by Ian Rankin. Hatchet Book Group, Little Brown. Cop Town by Karen Slaughter, Penguin Random House, Delaporte Books. And the Edgar, and there's only one of these, goes to Mr. Mercedes, Stephen King.
This is wonderful, but it's late, and I've got a very old dog back in a hotel with a very weak bladder. It's been a very long night, so I'm going to make this brief. I want to thank everybody at Table 19, particularly all my Scribner's buddies. Roz LaPelle is there, and Nan Graham, Susan Moldau, and of course, my agent, Chuck Verrill, who I've been with ever since he looked like he couldn't buy a drink legally in a bar. Those days are gone, Chuck, but still, well, for me too. And best of all, my wife. We haven't been married 50 years, but it's going on 43 now. It's been a real wonderful partnership in every way imaginable. And this is great. I want to say one thing, and then I'm going to stop. I had the idea for Mr. Mercedes on a road when I was taking my morning walk, and that's where ideas sometimes come. And the first thing I thought was, I can't write this book, although the idea is pretty good, because it isn't the sort of thing that I do. And at some point on that walk, I physically stopped moving and said, is this what you worked for 40 years? To say that you can't write a really good idea because it doesn't have a horror theme or it doesn't have, you know, an ESP theme or because it's something that you never tried to do before, because I've written mystery novels all my life, and I didn't think that I could ever write one or write this kind of book. And I said, after all you've been through and after all you've done, if you turn down a good idea, you're a fucking asshole. So, and man, I got to thank the publisher, who also knew it wasn't what I do ordinarily, and they just sort of put on their big boy pants and said, you go ahead, go with it, Steve. And so I wrote this book, and all I can say is that Hodges and his friends are going to be back next month, and next year there's going to be a third one, and unfortunately the bad guy, Brady Hartsfield, will be back too. And listen, all of you, God love you. Thanks a lot.